if in consulting it said that, you know, you are given a, you know, broken airplane, which you have to sort of salvage as it is going down. I think in entrepreneurship, you're not even given any airplane. You have to build it on the way down and make sure that you land safe. Hi guys, I am Pritish and I am the Chief Business and Operations Officer at Dozee. Welcome to Backstage with Millionaires. And today I'm going to be talking about how the world of a consultant looks like versus the world of an entrepreneur and why I decided to make a switch from being a consultant to an entrepreneur. So I graduated from IIT Bombay, and right after college, you know, you have tons of options of either going into a consulting firm or a finance firms, or, you know, going into a core technology firms. And given all of those options, you know, consulting felt like the best option for me because, you know, it's a really high paying job. You know, the smartest people work there, the smartest of the seniors that you know about work there. You have, you know, so-called very glamorous life wherein you're traveling to all across the globe, or, you know, you're living in five-star hotels. And more importantly, you're working across industries and learning really, really fast, and you have a steep learning curve. So from all those perspectives, you know, it made a lot of sense, and hence I joined Boston Consulting Group, you know, one of the top consulting firms, management consulting firms in the world. And so I was there for a couple of years where I worked with Ministry of India, worked with top banks in India, worked with oil and gas firms, and all of that was great. You know, I was making good money, I was learning a lot, and I was working with smartest of folks. But I just felt that I could maybe use my most energetic days to take a bit of risk so that I can have a chance of making a huge impact in the world. And that is when I thought of becoming an entrepreneur and joined a very early stage startup, Dozee. It's a health tech startup which is reimagining the way healthcare is experienced by each one of us. And so entrepreneurial life, you know, it's exciting, but at the same time super challenging, because if in consulting it said that, you know, you are given a, you know, broken airplane, which you have to sort of salvage as it is going down. I think in entrepreneurship, you're not even given any airplane. You have to build it on the way down and make sure that you land safe. So those are the two, you know, I think that's the best way to explain how consulting life is versus an entrepreneurial life. So yeah, just looking back, I think both entrepreneurship and consulting are similar in the way that it's hard work. There's no denying that. And you're working with smart people day in, day out. You know, in consulting, you have smart people inside the company and you're working with CEOs and, you know, VPs and managers. And in entrepreneurship, you have built a great team, smart team. And at the same time, you're working with smart VCs, businesses. So I think it's in those aspects, it's similar. But where it really starts getting different is, you know, very obviously, you being a manager versus, you know, being an employee. In startup, you really have to start managing not only yourself, but also, you know, people with you, under you. That's a very big difference, very big shift that you have to do right at the outgo. The second thing, because of which, is you tend to have a bit more control over your life in startup as compared to consulting, again, because sometimes there's less predictability, especially with a client being involved in the mix. You tend to have less predictability in consulting world. But, you know, again, in startup world, you know, you don't tend to make so much money. You might have more control, but you don't have make so much money versus a consulting where, you know, you have great, you know, financials, five-star hotels, and so on. For me, it was all worth it because the kick I get from solving a problem is too big, you know, to go into the depths of those problems and not just be skimming through, you know, wide variety of problems, but to go into the depths of those problems, which, you know, entrepreneurship gives to me. is really, really satisfying. And for me, what matters is that, you know, I'm on the driving seat, driving the car, and not just sitting on the, you know, on the pillion seat and guiding the driver. And so it all depends on you. Both of these are great lives. Are you okay with a bit less control but more money versus more control, less money? And you know, all the equation is for you to solve. I'll leave it. For me, entrepreneurship made more sense. But even with that decision, you might face some hurdles in terms of society and your family, your parents especially. So I think society, the times are really changing. 5-10 years back, consulting would have been a clear win and startups would have been a clear no-no. It's still a bit lopsided. Startup would be maybe 30 and consulting would be 70. But that gap is narrowing down a bit more. Society is starting to perceive entrepreneurship very positively. But I think it will boil down to your parents and your relatives, which you will need to solve for. And you should know that your parents come from a certain background of how they've seen the life. In their time, startup meant a huge amount of money, and if you failed, then no option in the world. So they come from that background. So it's natural for them to feel apprehension about you starting up. How I dealt with it, I made a gradual shift. I started working simultaneously on both the projects, and it just gave me more clarity to me as well that what's my true calling. And once I was convinced of it, I was able to convince my parents and my relatives as well, and I made the shift to entrepreneurship. And so while I was evaluating it for myself, I looked at two main things. One is the team I'm going to work with. I think that's the most important thing while making a jump to a startup. Team is what defines really a startup. And then the second thing is how passionate are you about the whole idea? And if you have to really evaluate how to, you know, really quantify this impact that, you know, all of us keep talking about, I thought of it in a very consulting way of building a, you know, model around it. So there are three factors which define this model. One is, you know, how many people can potentially get impacted or how many people would actually use your services or your product. The second thing is how frequently will they use your product or services. And the third thing is, if they were to use it per transaction, how much amount will they be willing to ascribe to it, or how much would they be willing to pay for it? And so if you combine all of these three factors, you would understand that, you know, a Swiggy model is very different from a Make My Trip model or a Redbus model, right? These have very different parameters as a business. So it really comes down, you know, to these factors of, you know, team, your passion, and the impact that you can use as a mental model for you to get convinced whether it's worth it to be an entrepreneur or be a consultant. So there you go, guys. I hope this video was helpful to you. And if you know anybody who is dabbling with this whole question of consulting versus entrepreneurship, do share this video with them. And if you have some queries or some, you know, comments on this, do leave it below. Do leave your comment below, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. And hey, do check us out at www.dozee.io. We have built the most user-friendly health monitor ever and are trying to make healthcare very user-friendly and, you know, for you, for your parents, for your loved ones, everybody.
You want to take back the outcome and you're listening. Okay. Yeah.